This is a tutorial where we're all going to learn how to turn this into this. I'll be using Photoshop CC 2017 and we'll be cropping the photograph and doing a little bit of contrast stuff to get an image ready for the internet. So, first things first, I will find the rulers. I never know where things are, I always just go to search rulers. And you can click on it right here. This will give you a ruler on the top and the side of the image. If you grab the ruler and pull it down, you can actually drag some lines in that we can use as a reference. So, I'm just doing that. I'm just trying to bring them to the edges of the painting on each side. Doesn't have to be perfect. As you can see, the photograph was a little bit skewed. Anyway, that's what we're about to clean up here. So, what I'm going to want to do first is unlock the layer, because I'm going to be doing some warping here, and it can be a little tricky if it's the locked layer. So, I want to go over to the layer panel and uncheck the little lock mark here. So, now it is free to go. The next thing that I've got to figure out is what I want to do first. If I go Command T, that'll help transform it, and I can just start warping my image to fit the parameters. But I don't think I'm gonna do that quite yet. It's easy to warp a picture too much. So before I do that, I'm gonna skew it. Skewing's a little different. That's just taking the corners and moving them. There's less of a chance of radically warping your image that way. So we're just gonna start out by skewing it. And what I'm doing is I'm grabbing the corners of the photograph and I'm keeping my eye on the edge of the canvas. And I'll just try to get each corner into its own spot. So it's a little bit finicky. Every time you move one of these corners, it kind of moves all the other four. So you may have to chase it around a few times before you have it all lined up. But at this point, this is actually looking pretty good to me. So I'll apply the transformation and then we can get into the nitty-gritty of the exact edge coming up next. So I'm going to want to do Command T for this one, and we're going to actually do some warping here. So I'll hit Command T and the warping grid. So this is the one where you can just grab anywhere and it'll really warp your image. Again, it's easy to overdo this and find everything warped around. So you want to use it very, very selectively and carefully. But if you just run around the perimeter here, I can very carefully grab the image from any point and pretty much push it and pull it any way I want. So I'm basically trying to get the very edge of the canvas right up against here so that when I crop it, you can see the image ends right where the canvas ends. I'm even going to try to keep in that little shiny line on the right-hand side. You can just see it, and it's glare from the light source that I had when I took the photograph. I think a lot of people would want to probably try to crop that out and pretend that the canvas goes on forever, but I like actually having a little bit of shading on the image of the painting. It makes it look more like a three-dimensional object to me in space, and I think that's appealing. So yeah, at this point I've got it just about good. You can see it splays out a little bit in that corner, but that's all right. It doesn't have to be perfect. So from here, the next step is to grab the box, and I'll go to one corner and just pull it down. One nice thing about these blue guides I set up, they'll actually, box will snap to those guides. So now I can go crop, and we have the cropped image. This is the one I'll be using. So as I pull the guides away, you can get a clearer idea of what the edges look like. This is just what I wanted. Although, as you can see, there's a few things we could change about the image itself. The darks aren't that dark, nor are the lights as light as they could be. I don't want to do too much contrast, but it might be worth playing around with. You can get some, maybe we can get those bushes a little bit darker, for instance. So I'll try out the auto tone, auto contrast, and auto color. With each one of these, it's the computer making the decision, so it can come out good or terrible. Yeah, that looks awful. That doesn't look anything like the painting, so let's try the next one, auto contrast. That's pretty good. All right, let's try this last one. Now with each of these, when I take it away, I just go Command Z, that undoes the previous action. So I can try out things and then just take it back right away. Yeah, I think auto contrast is probably gonna be the way to go. auto color. Yeah, that one looks good too. Both look pretty similar to me. So that right there actually did a lot of help. The darks are darker, the light's lighter, and yet I didn't lose any information in the really dark parts. One thing I'm noticing though is that down here in the lower right, it's a little bit lighter than any of the sky up in the upper left. It's because the light source is down here. So I want to correct for that. Now we're really getting into photo manipulation. So this could easily go from being a photograph of my painting to being a multimedia image that was in paint and digital painting. I don't want to have that, and I feel like as long as I'm very subtle with just lightening up a few things, I can still say that this is a photograph of a painting. Kind of comes down to your own personal philosophy on what art is, I suppose, but I think just some very subtle manipulation, just to make your photograph look more like the actual painting does in real life, I'd say that's a-okay. So what I'm doing here is I'm using the dodge tool, I should have said, just to lighten things up a little bit. Now you could use the burn tool, that'll darken things, or the sponge tool, which we can saturate or desaturate the colors in the image. This whole image is actually pretty saturated, but it's supposed to be. That's what it looks like in real life. So I'd say this is just about good to go. It is ready for the internet. I'm gonna put a little watermark in here. Now, you know, if people wanted to, they could totally steal this painting and take the watermark out, but I like to add it just as a habit. So I'm going to type in, let's see, I'll put the cursor down here. I'll do art by Garth, capital B, Garth, capital G-A-R-T-H. And I'll change the font to my Garth font. Maybe mess with the opacity a little bit here. Well, actually, that's looking all right. Let's make the font a little bit bigger, though. Go down to the character box, and if you grab a hold of the actual little icon for the size, you can just pull to the right, and it'll drag it up for you. That's a pretty good size. Yeah, as I zoom out on the whole picture, it's a bit distracting. I'll just take the opacity down somewhat here. And there's looking pretty nice. So, yep. I'd say that's a hit. That's done. We'll go up here to file, and we will we'll save as. And now I have to try to remember what the name of this painting is. Gold Diggers. I named it Gold Diggers. So we'll call it that, and make it a JPEG because that's a somewhat smaller type of file. Go up on the internet. Now, as it calculates, yeah, 8.6 megabytes is pretty big. But you know, it is a big file. So that's it. That's the whole tutorial. Hope y'all learned something. Good night.